Hi everyone, this is Professor Mayungar and you are watching Uda Plus, the professional CAD/CAM solution provider. Let's get started. Hello, yes. Today I'm going to show safety aerodynamics of a Boeing 747 using SOLIDWORKS 2022. You can see this is the model and we need to perform one external analysis. And in our analysis, we can do a lot of things, like we can have the drag force and also coefficient of drag, because in aerodynamics our main aim is to reduce the drag, and in this case we'll be concentrating our analysis only on results in the form of pressure and velocity at different cut points, and also we'll see dynamics of flow particles to the body. We'll see the variation of pressure and velocity at different parts of the body. Our drag force and also coefficient drag can be done later on, right? So that's just in time. Let us start our analysis. First of all, we start from simulation, and flow simulation environment will be initiated with this flow simulation. Next to that, we need to start with the wizard, and we are keeping the name of the project as default project 2. We are not changing anything, right? Next to that, we need to select unit system. We are considering SI system as the standard one, and from different parameters, we'll consider pressure as Pascal and temperature will be in degree centigrade. Though temperature is not having any effect in this case, but as for normal practice, we're considering temperature as in degree centigrade. Next to that, we need to consider what type of analysis it is. Definitely, it is an external analysis. Definitely, gravity is having an effect, so we're selecting gravity. Let us check the direction of gravity. You can see here, direction of gravity is actually y, and it will be in the downward direction. So we can check it from here. Gravity in the y direction is -9.81 meter per second square, and along z it will be 0. Done. Next to that, we're considering gases. It is air, and flow type it will be laminar and turbulent. Next to that, default wall thermal conditions and roughness we are considering. And finally, we need to select thermodynamic parameters. Pressure is 10135 Pascal and temperature is 2105 degrees centigrade. The temperature is not having any kind of effect here itself, so we'll not bother about temperature. And here in this case, velocity of air is very important thing. Let us see the direction of velocity of air, because plane will be moving in z direction, so air will be moving in the opposite of z direction, right? So let us consider the velocity of air will be -410 meter per second in the opposite direction of z, so it will be -410 meter per second. Let us finish this. Now you can see this is our computational domain, right? So computational domain, we need to set it because some part of the plane is outside this domain. So what can we do is we can change it from here itself. Like, see the computational domain, we can edit it, change the orientation of this one. From this side it is okay. Now we need to change from other side, right? So let us view it from other side. Done. Now you can see it from front view also. You can see it from front end. This one can be also reduced a little bit. Done. This is our computational domain. This is very important part, because higher the volume of computational domain, it will take much time for calculations. So to reduce calculation time, we are reducing the computational domain. We can check. Now we can hide this domain. This is our model, right? Actually, for boundary conditions, we have applied everything. We need to select some goals at this moment. In this case, we'll be considering two different types of goals. One will be global goal, another will be surface goals, right? Let us select global goals. From here, we can select average total pressure, average velocity, and also we can select force in the y direction. These are the things we want to see from our goal plots, right? So we want to see average total pressure, average velocity, and also force in the upward direction. That is uplifting force, right? Excluding that, we can see surface goods also. We can see pressure distribution, velocity distribution, etc. over the entire surface of this body, right? But that is not our main aim. Our aim is to see the dynamics of flow particles through the body. So we'll skip this part. Next to that, we need to go for meshing. Let us start with mesh, and we can go for global mesh. What can we do is we can go for manual meshing, and we can go for further refinement. So display refinement level, and we can refine this one a better way. This is refined up to level 1. We can refine this one up to level 3. Because better the meshing, we can expect better results, right? Just based on mesh size, convergence criteria will be achieved, right? Okay, so gain check. Everything is done. Excluding these things, we can give some kind of equation goals. And from these equation goals, you can find out drag force and coefficient drag, etc. In this case, we want to show only the dynamics of flow particles and different cut plots of pressure and velocity from different planes, right? So let us run this one. We're running this one with the new calculations, right? So let us run it. Iterations have already started. Let the iterations move on. Whenever it is finished, we'll see the results and go for detailed analysis, right? You can see our solver is finished. Now you can see our results. We'll initiate our results from cut plots. So insert cut plots, and we'll see the different pressure and velocity distribution from front plane. And we want to see the results in the form of contours, isolines, and vectors. And let us see streamlined also. And you can see contours of pressure. Next to that, we'll see velocity distribution also. So grain check. Let us view it in the form of animation, right? Display. This is pressure distribution from front end. Different colors are indicating different pressure zone, right? At different locations, we are having different pressures, right? We can see near the blades and also near the propeller at the tail also, pressure distribution is different. It is little bit less at these locations, right? You can see it. You can see here near the propeller zone, pressure is in the blue zone. It is in the range of 35,053.04 Pascal. It is very less. And also at the tail also it is less, right? Now instead of pressure, you can see velocity also. Let us change it to velocity distribution. Let us see it from front plane. Like the previous case, we can see velocity distribution at the different zones are different. And maximum velocity is at red zone, which is in the range of 498.478 meter per second. And near the propeller, we are having mixed zone. It is 323.319 to 387 meter per second. Let us orient this one and check it again. This is velocity distribution from front plane. Now we'll change the orientation. Instead of front plane, we'll check it in the right plane, right? So let us close this part. Cut plot 1, clear and hide, and we'll edit this one, right? So cut plot 1, edit definition, and instead of front plane, we'll see it from right plane. Let us see it from YZ plane, and we'll see the same parameters like contours of velocity with isolines vectors and streamlines also. Grand check. Now we can view this in the form of animation, right? Let's change the orientation from right to left and display it. This is countries of velocity at different locations. You can view it from this way also. Again, it is clearly evident that near the propeller solely, it is having different values, and through the body it is streamlined. At the propeller, it is in the blue zone. That means it is less. And again, you can see at some specific location we are having red zone also, that is having high velocities, right? So through the color distribution, we can see velocity and pressure distribution at different zones, right? Next to that, we'll change this velocity distribution to pressure distribution, right? So instead of velocity, let's change it to pressure. Let us view it from right plane. This is pressure distribution from right plane. You can see at different locations, different pressures, and the color zone specifies pressure at different zones with different values, right? Actually, dark blue is less pressure and lighter blue is actually little bit of higher pressure. You can see the pressure values at the left hand side also, right? Let us clear and hide. Next to that, we want to see dynamics of flow particles. That is our main task. So flow trajectories, insert, and we can select this one in the form of rectangles. Instead of 20 numbers, let us make this one 100. Grand check. Let us play this. You can see it from different planes. Also, different color zones are there. Dark blue is less pressure and lighter blue is little bit of higher pressure. Let us change it to velocity. You can see velocity distribution. This is dynamics of flow particles. That means how air particles are moving across the planes, right? And at different zones where air particles are actually striking the plane, we can find the velocities and pressure at different zones also, and that will be viewed from the goal plots, right? So let us close this one. Clear and hide. Next to that, we want to see our goal plots, right? So goal plots, insert goal plots, and we want to see all the results. We can transfer this data to Excel for better analysis, or we can see it from here itself. Let us show it here itself. And you can see this one in the form of data. We can view it in the form of graph also from summary. Let us see the history. Let us see it in a better way. First one is actually total pressure. It is showing that initially pressure was very high, and we can see after 205 numbers of iterations, pressure is 242,292.172 Pascal. Similarly, for the velocity one, we can see initially velocity was 410 meter per second, and here after 206 numbers of iterations, you can see velocity is 47.88 meter per second, and also the force in the y direction. You can see here after 208 numbers of iterations, that force is minus 312.97 meter per second, right? These are all the results, and we can transfer all these data to Excel also for better analysis, right? This was a very simple analysis. Actually, I wanted to show aerodynamics of a Boeing 747 through pressure and velocity distribution from different cut plots, and also wanted to show the dynamics of flow particles. So this is done, and next analysis will show the calculation of drag force and also the drag coefficient through equation goals, right? So with this one, we'll conclude our today's video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye. If you like this video, please subscribe and share, and if you have any kind of doubts, please write to me. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you again. Bye.